All right, I'd like to talk to you for a minute about ratios. A few of you said you were struggling with those here in our drug calculations. So a ratio is simply a comparison. Just like the fraction 1 to 4, it's a comparison of 1 to 4. So let's start out with a comparison or a ratio problem. So we have 4 is compared to x as 2 is compared to 3. So when I solve these, the first thing I do is I call rainbow it. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna multiply the outside and we're gonna multiply the insides, okay? So if we do that, we have 4 times 3 equals 12. Okay, everybody got that? So 4 times 3 and x times 2 equals 2x. So 12 equals 2x. Now the next thing that we have to do with math, you always have to remember if we solve for x, what we do to one side, we have to do with the other side. So we're going to divide both sides by 2, so the x will stand alone. So we have 12 divided by 2 equals 2x divided by 2. 12 divided by 2 is 6. 2x divided by 2 is x. So the answer to our problem is 6. Let's try another one. All right, here we go. So we have 100 is to x as 5 is to 1. So remember, let's rainbow it, and then we got to solve for x. So rainbow it, 100 times 1 and x times 5. So we have 100 equals 5x. And we're going to divide both sides times 5 so that x will stand alone. And x equals 20. Now let's do one with our drug calculations, okay? So the first thing you want to make sure when you're using ratios is that you compare hearts to squares, or milligrams to milliliters. It must be the same unit measurement. If it isn't, you can't use the ratio, okay? So if you were trying to figure out how many grams something was, you would have to change that to milligrams first and then plug it into your ratio. Just as we have here, 100 milligrams is to 1 ml, as 250 milligrams is to x ml, okay? So let's put it in a problem. Our physician's orders for 250 milligrams of a medication. Our bottle shows we have 100 milligrams per 1 ml. And how many ml will we give? So first you want to put down what you know. We know by the bottle that 100 milligrams is 1 ml. Our physician has ordered 250 milligrams, and how many mLs will that be? So again, we want to rainbow it. 100 times x and 1 times 250. When we do that, we get 100x equals 250. And again, we want the x to stand alone, so we're going to divide both sides by 100. So 100x divided by 100 equals x. 250 divided by 100 is 2.5 ml. Okay? Pretty easy stuff. I love ratios. You can kind of see it a little bit more than you can with the formula method. But let's go ahead and double check with our formula method, which is our desired over half times quantity. Our desired or doctor's dose is 250 milligrams. We have 100 milligrams per 1 ml. So if we do the math, 250 divided by 100 times 1 ml, we get 2.5 ml. Well, that's ratios. I hope that helps. Stick with it and just practice. You got this.